What is up, guys? Dan from the Elite Four Crew coming at you with the quarterfinals of the Elite Four Crew PokerTuber Championship. Kicking things off, you can have a look at the tournament ladder here. Today we've got Mighticus against Scotty Josh Pepper, Badded Caterpie against Dragon Tamer Blade, we've got Danicky against myself, Elite Four Dan, and DM Puff against Badger and Cup. So to kick things off, we've got Mighticus against Scotty Josh Pepper. If you have a look at the teams, we've got Scotty Josh Pepper decides to bring the Ferrothorn, the Politoed, the Swampert, the Manaphy, the Sylveon, the Kieran B. Sticking with that rain team, whilst Mighticus goes for the Landorus Therian, the Gengar, the Gyarados, the Ferrothorn, the Kieran B, and the Raikou. So let's have a look, see what happens. Ferrothorn comes out for Scotty Josh Pepper with the Landorus coming out for Mighticus. The Stealthrock comes in with the training Stealthrocks here, and the U-turns out of there. Takes some Iron Barbs and Rocky Helmet damage as Mighticus brings out his own Ferrothorn. Iron Head comes in, and the Ferrothorn takes Iron Barbs. Spikes now from Mighticus, Thunder Waves, the Ferrothorn. Trading blows, kind of, these two aren't going to do much to each other, so the Politoed comes out now, and it makes it rain as Mighticus' Ferrothorn gets fully powered, which is unfortunate. And the Politoed goes for a Perish Song, gets fully powered again, which is really, really unfortunate then. It goes for a Scald, gets a crit 39% in the rain, Leech Seed comes in, both perishing in two. The Politoed switches out smartly as the Swampert decides to come in. The Ferrothorn does get out another layer of spikes, and it will surely switch out this turn, which it does, switching it into the Gyarados. Intimidates the Swampert as it Mega Evolves, goes for an Earthquake and is immune. The Swampert switches out into the Kieran B as the Gyarados decides to Mega Evolve itself and goes for a Waterfall, resisted in the rain, then switches out. The Ferrothorn comes back out now for Mighticus. The Fusion Bolt comes in, resisted, and that's not going to take any damage because it's not a physical attack. It doesn't make contact, sorry. But Leech Seed misses from Mighticus, which is unfortunate. As Scotty Josh Pepper decides to bring out the Politoed yet again. Drizzle comes in, taking a lot of damage from Spikes and Stealth Rock. Got all of his hazards up now, Mighticus. As the Scald comes in, does 26%. Ferrothorn's job is done now here. Goes for another Scald, resisted 24% as the half gets fully powered again. Four times the Ferrothorn's been fully powered, which is unfortunate. Goes for the Protect, Scald comes in, getting a little bit of HP back. Not sure if it'll be enough to protect him from the Scald. It is just about fully powered again, wow. Five times fully powered from Mighticus, which is really unfortunate. Gets Protect, Scald. This Scald will take it out. Oh, it decides to switch out into the Gyarados now. Moldbreaker Gyarados takes this Scald, no problems. As it starts Dragon Dancing, this is a problem now. The Toxic comes in, and the rain goes away. Politoed decides to switch out to the Ferrothorn. Smart play, as it goes for a Rest. Rest Gyarados from Mighticus. Really, really nice play. So the Ferrothorn comes back out from Mighticus. Leech Seed comes in, obviously immune to that. These Ferrothorns can't really touch each other. Mighticus just getting a bit of leftovers damage back. As decides to switch out again, and the Landorus comes out. Iron Head comes in, does nothing to the Landorus. It goes for an Earthquake and does take out the Ferrothorn. So that is another problem gone for... That's the first kill of the game, actually, and as the Politoed goes down to hazards, as so does the Kieran B. These hazards stacking really has made a world of difference. Look at all that, 63% from that. Ice Beam comes in, no problem at all for the Manaphy. As Mighticus brings out his own Kieran B. Goes for a Fusion Bolt and takes out the Manaphy. We'll come out next. The Mega Swampert comes out. Kieran B switches out into the Mega Gyarados, which is still asleep. Waterfall comes in, resisted. Really, really nice play from Mighticus. Super power, super effective, 63%. Gets the attack and defense drop on the Mega Swampert. And the Waterfall finishes it off. Mighticus brings out the Gengar now. Goes for an Energy Ball. Obviously takes it out. Quad weak. And shows the life orb there. As the Sylveon comes out and will take this Sludge Wave, or won't take it very well at all. It goes down, and that is the win for Mighticus. Really, really good game from these two. Two really, really good battles. And that victory puts Mighticus into the semi-finals. So let's find out who's going to play between Bandit Caterpie and Dragon Tamer Blade. Bandit Caterpie brings the Clefable, the Conkeldurr, the Kieran B, the Raikou, the Landorus T, and the Alakazam. Whilst DT Blade decides to go for the Metagross, the Kieran B, the Latios, the Raikou, the Azumarill, and the Landorus T. So pretty similar teams, to be fair. But we'll see what happens here. Bandicap, he leads off with Landorus, whilst DT Blade leaves off with the Kieran B. Starts to switch out, switch on the Scarf. They both double out. Azumarill and Conkeldurr up together now, as Bandicap goes back out into the Landorus. Takes his player off, 39%, no problems at all, and gets hit with the Rocky Helmet. Starts to switch out, Landorus comes out here, takes a Stealth Rock, U-turns out of there, Bandicap, he's Landorus, and takes Rocky Helmet damage. So two Rocky Helmet Landorus being run here, as DT Blade gets his own rocks up. The Ice Beam comes in and takes out the Landorus. I'm not sure why DT Blade decided to stay in there. Obviously deciding that his Landorus had done enough, apparently. The Claymore comes out now, takes the side shot, 64%. Wow. Another side shot comes in, and Claymore goes down. Wow, I wasn't expecting that. And Raikou comes out now for Bandicap. Latios retreats and brings out his own Raikou now. As Bandicap sets up a sub. Sets up a sub with his Raikou and starts calm winding away. This could be dangerous for DT Blade. Goes for a Volt Switch, does get a crit, which probably made a difference. Probably made a difference in fading that substitute as the Metagross comes out now. Mega Evolve and goes for another substitute here, Bandicap, as the Earthquake comes in, obviously super effective. Goes for a Thunderbolt, 74%, not quite enough as the Ice Punch comes in. Really interesting play from DT Blade, obviously expecting the Landorus to come out. But it is a misplay, which it was a prediction that's gone wrong for him, unfortunately. The Azumarill comes out now. Aqua Jet comes in. A critical hit, don't think it matters. Does take out the Raikou as Bandicap, he brings out his own Landorus. Another Aqua Jet does take it out, cuts from Rocky Helmet damage to the Azumarill. But it's putting in some work here, this little blue rabbit. DT Blade switches out to his Raikou to face the Conkeldurr of Bandicap. Thunder Punch comes in, is resisted, gets the crit though, 33% damage. Thunderbolt comes in, 46%, not quite enough. The Drain Punch comes in and takes out the Raikou, getting a bit of HP back for himself there. The Azumarill comes out now, goes for a Play Rough, which will take out the Conkeldurr with no problems whatsoever. As the Alakazam comes in now, doesn't take any rocks damage due to Wonder Guard, Magic Guard. Mega Evolves, takes the Trace as well, and Psychic is resist, 32%, it'll be enough though. Shadow Ball comes in, takes out the Latios. We could be in for an Alakazam sweep here. Alakazam goes for Focus Blast, hits it. Focus Miss, as a lot of people like to call it, but it does not miss there. As the Azumarill comes out now, Aqua Jets does 77%, not quite enough. And the Psychic comes in and takes out the Azumarill. So that is a win for Bandicap, putting him into the semi-final against Monikus. Really, really good game again from these guys. The quality in this tournament is really starting to show at this stage now. So moving on to the next quarterfinal match. It is Danicky against myself, Elite Four Dan. So I was nervous for this because Danicky has destroyed everyone that's come up against him so far, including Tom. So I wanted to do this for Tom. I really wanted to do this for Tom. So Danicky decides to bring the Metagross, the Tornadus T, the Excadrill, the Rotom Wash, the Clefable, and the Kieran Black. Whilst I brought the Rotom Wash, the Landorus T, Heatran, the Metagross, the Tangrowth, and the Latios. So, look, Kieran B being featured heavily in this tournament, so I decided not to bring one. But anyway, the Tornadus against the Landorus. Tornadus switches out and my Landorus U-turns out, bringing in the Heatran against his Clefable. So he decides to switch out into Beatdown as I go for a Stealth Rock. Now he Earth Powers and takes out my Heatran. I forgot that I wasn't running Air Balloon. In League, in APA, I've been running Air Balloon Heatran the whole time. I forgot that I wasn't running. I go for a Draco, he switches the Clefable in, obviously immune to that, so it does nothing. I bring the Metagross out as he doubles that into his Excadrill. Really, really good play from him, as I decide to switch out, not wanting to catch an Excadrill. Earthquake, as I forget that Excadrill has Mold Breaker, and I bring out my Rotom Wash, which gets absolutely destroyed by the Earthquake. So really, really poor play from my part there. And I put myself on the back foot from turn 6, so not a good start at all. I then decide to bring out the Landorus as he switches out his Excadrill, as I probably decide to go for a knockoff, okay. Knock off the leftovers of the Rotom Wash, switch out to the Latios to take this Will-O-Wisp, which is absolutely fine. He switches out his Rotom Wash into Gongivitia, the Mega Metagross. Sideshot comes in, does absolutely nothing. I take some burn damage and some life orb damage. I switch out into my own Landorus, get the Intimidate, obviously clear body. Now it starts to Mega Evolve and goes for a Rock Polish. Now this is dangerous. Ice Punch takes out the Landorus. I bring out the Sandgrove. Decides to switch out. Not sure why. I get the Leech Seed off. Obviously, it does nothing. It's a Clefable with Wonder Guard, Magic Guard. I keep calling it Wonder Guard. I bring out my own Metagross now. As he decides to bring out his Tornadus. Really, really good play from him. As he doubles out into the Rotom Wash. And doesn't quite take the Thunder Punch. The Rotom Wash goes down. So I get my first kill. Which is nice. As the Extra Drill comes out here. I had no choice but to take that, really. The Ice Punch comes in, critical hit 75%. And I get the freeze. And I hit him. I was really, like, it was going to happen. Like, it wasn't going to happen, but, you know, he was winning. I think the match was lost by this point, so I didn't feel too bad about getting the freeze. Knockoff comes in on the Latios as I roost up. We lose our life orb and we keep getting burn damage. The Hurricane comes in and misses. As I go for another roost, just trying to do something with this. The U-turn's out of there, as it goes into Gongiritia, as I come in with another Side Shock, which does absolutely nothing. I have no choice here, but to just take this Ice Punch, let it go down, as the Tangrowth comes out now. And he decides to switch out again. I don't know why he's not Ice Punching my Tangrowth. Maybe expecting Rocky Helmet. Could be the only reason. And he decides to Carmine up. And he's Carminding, taking his Grass Knots for days, soft boiled. This game is won. And he's toying with me at this stage. He's just Carminding, just making sure of it. Carmine again. Grass Knot comes in. I said, finish it. He does. Oh, it does 4%. Leaves it at 4%, which is a bit of an anticlimactic finish, but he does get the finish in the end. So that was a really good game with Danakia. I really, really enjoyed it. He's an absolutely amazing battler. To knock both myself and Tom out of the tournament, it was no easy feat. So congrats to him, and he moves on into the semi-finals. Now, let's find out who he's going to play. DM Puff against Badger and Carl. The DM Puff got into the quarterfinals through a forfeit, but whilst Badger and Carl beat CC's me. So I was really interested to see this match, because I thought this was going to be a really, really good matchup between these two. They both said good luck and have fun, so that's nice. DM Puff brings the Talonflame, the Fable, the Espeon, the Bisharp, the Rotom Wash, and the Venusaur. While Badger and Carp bring the Heatran, the Dragonite, the Talonflame, the Landorus T, the Rotom Wash, and the Ferrothorn. So let's see how this goes down. DM Puff leads with the Bisharp, as Badger leads with the Landorus. Gets the Defiant boost there, the Bisharp. Sucker Punch isn't quite enough to take out the Landorus. As Landorus decides to switch out now, the Bisharp goes for a knockoff. Does 51%, takes the Iron Barbs damage, and removes the leftovers of the Ferrothorn. Decides to switch out now, as the Talonflame comes in. Gets hit with the Leech Seed, which is no problem. Decides to switch out again into the Venusaur, as Badger and Carp doubles out into the Heatran. The Venusaur obviously retreats there, as Rotom Wash comes in. Misses the Magma Storm anyway. And the Heatran doubles out into his own Rotom Wash there, Badger and Carp. Bulk Switch does 25%, goes out into the Mega Venusaur. I assume it's Mega. There it is, there's the Mega. The Will-O-Wisp comes in. Not really a huge problem. Misses the Sleep Powder there, DM Puff, which is unfortunate, but that's the game we play. Bulk Switch comes in, does absolutely nothing, 10%, but pivots out into the Talonflame. Gets Giga Drained, resisted, does absolutely nothing. And now, what will the Talonflame do here? The Venusaur decides to switch out into the Rotom Wash. As the Talonflame decides to Sword Dance up, so this is scary now. Acrobatics comes in, resisted only 45%, as the Hydro Pump comes in and takes out the Talonflame. So Badger and Carp losing the first Pokemon of the match. Volt Switch comes in from DM Puff on the Ferrothorn, as his own Talonflame comes out. Misses the Power Whip there, Nigel Thornberry, which is unfortunate, but it wouldn't have done too much anyway. Overheat, Flash Fire, Heatran, doing what it does best, and will now dish out a Magma Storm of its own. Does 31%, not quite enough, but the Rotom gets trapped in the swirling lava. It just has to switch out here, the Heatran, and gets pain-splitted there. So both Hopwids out, both Rotom washes. Volt switches out Badger and Carp into his Landorus T, gets the Intimidate off, goes for a Volt Switch, obviously immune, as he decides to go for a U-turn, just a bit more chip damage, and goes out into his own Rotom Wash. Resisted to Hydro Pump, 22%. Pain Split from the DM Puff. Bolt Switch comes in, does 21%, switches back out into the Landorus T as another U-turn here. Oh, it decides to switch out, saving his Rotom, but a poor switching, bringing the Espeon in on the U-turn, takes 80% there. Brink sets up the Reflect, and the Espeon goes down. So it sets up one Reflect, which isn't going to do too much, I think, in the foreseeable future, as he's got a lot of special mons, Badger and Carp still. But the Talonflame does a Brave Bird, doesn't do much. Sets up a Tailwind now, as the Toxic comes in from the Heatran. This Talonflame's got to do something. Decides to switch out, goes into the Rotom Wash, and gets taunted. Okay, so no pain splitting there for this Rotom. As the Heatran switches out into his own Rotom Wash, gets Volt Switched, brings him down to 14% as the Mega Venusaur comes back in. Gets Giga Drained, and the Hot Point goes down. So Dimpuff takes a lead in this match, as Badger Carp starts to bring out the Dragonite, gets sets up the sub on the Sleep Powder. Really, really good play from him. The Reflect is still up though, but one a Dragon Dance turn will sort that out. Does Dragon Dance as the Clefable comes in, so no Dragon Claws today. Goes for an Earthquake, which is a 49%. The Reflect is gone. The Moonblast does take out the substitute. They decide not to risk the high roll, as the Moonblast comes in on Nigel Thornberry. Does absolutely nothing. Fire Blast will do something though. Takes out the Ferrothorn. Now as 420 Blazer comes back out for Badger and Carp, as he switches out in the Talonflame. Already Toxic, so really good play from DM Puff. Really, really good play from him there. And sets up another Tailwind. Magmastorm comes in, gets resisted, but the Talonflame will go down to poison here, as the Heatran's leftovers bring it back up to full health. The Bisharp comes out, knocks off the leftovers, and the Earth Power comes in, takes out the Bisharp now. So Badger and Carp staging a comeback now. Rotom Wash comes out, Hydro Pump takes out the Heatran. Really, really close game here. The Dragonite comes out now. Will-O-Wisp, that is crippled. That is really, really bad news for Badger and Carp. Real bad news. The Rotom Wash switches out into the Fable. Dragon Dance comes in from Dragonite. But he's not going to be able to touch this Fable. Goes for another Dragon Dance. So nullifies that burn drop. But it's still not going to be enough to do any sort of damage to this. Goes against the Earthquake, 33%. Switch Sparrow comes in, Moonblast takes out the Dragonite, as now it's just left with the Landorus T on 7% HP. Earthquake does take out the Clefable. Mega Venusaur comes in, Earthquake does take out the Mega Venusaur. Oh my god. And he's locked into Earthquake. Oh, really, really. Oh, that's unfortunate. He's locked into Earthquake. Oh, wow. That was a really great battle. They shared a nice exchange after. You can't see this, but Badger and Carp said, they said GG. DMPuff says, that was a great battle. Badger says, good luck the rest of the way, I'm cheering for you. So that was really, really, really nice battle from these two. Really, really close. That, man, he was locked into, he was scarfed Earthquake, so that's why he, obviously couldn't beat the Rotom there. But another really, really close game. So that was really cool. That was a really fun battle. So, and that puts DMPuff into the semi-finals against Daneki. So, next episode, guys, we will have the two semi-final matches. We'll go over them a bit slower. We'll probably put the speed down to like normal. That will be coming out. This is coming out today, which is Monday. Semi-final will be out Tuesday. And Thursday will be the grand final. So, keep your eyes peeled for that. Thank you for watching, guys. I've been your boy, Luke4Dan. Peace.